Yells.
Hey guys, Wake Rider here. Today I'm playing a little free-for-all on Black Box. Now, I know a lot of people have said to me, Wake, can you show us free-for-all gameplay on Modern Warfare 3? And I was like, hey man, I can do that. After all, for some of you who do not know, my roots actually originated from free-for-all, but it was Resistance Fall of Man free-for-all is where my online multiplayer love blossomed out from. So I was like, all right, no big deal. You know, I played a little bit of free-for-all in COD 4, probably of all the Call of Duties. And then fell into Team Deathmatch a little bit more and more. I started dabbling with it in Resistance Fall of Man. I played, you know, probably 50-50 in COD 4. And then I started playing in Modern Warfare 2. And I started playing in World at War. I started playing more and more Team Deathmatch. Especially as my friends list grew, etc., etc. Using the ACR here, golden ACR, and I know a lot of people are like, hey man, you're using the golden ACR, that thing's overpowered. That thing's way overpowered, man. Every gun in Call of Duty apparently is overpowered. Especially since the new buff, you know, everybody's complaining about the M16 now, and it's like, you know, you can't make anybody happy, so it is a free-for-all. I don't play it much. This is like my second full game of free-for-all, and I was using the gun that I felt most comfortable with, so sue me. Anyways, you can see here, I really don't like Black Box too much as a map. I don't like the way it's set up. I think it's a very pretty map, and I think it's a lot of fun if people didn't camp, but you do get a lot of snipers on it too, so a lot of this using the ACR is going to be kind of like anti-sniping. Which, the MK14 is probably a little better suited for that. Or even if I broke out the 50 cal, I'm sure I would have been fine. In a free-for-all, I know a lot of people use the tactic where, you know, you protect a certain area. You designate, okay, I'm going to protect the airplane. I'm going to protect this house. I'm going to protect the house that's under construction. I'm going to protect the building that is falling down at the bottom of the map. I can't do that. I don't have ADD. I don't have ADHD. I just can't play like that. I've tried to play like that before. I've tried to be patient and all that, but I don't have enough. I just lose patience. I need to run around the map. I need to rush. I need to go find people. I need to play my style of game. And that's also very important, you know, because I know a lot of my friends on YouTube, especially, I can think of one certain guy. I don't want to call him out, but he's actually a very good free-for-all guy. He just plays it differently than me. You know, I don't disagree with how he plays it. It's just I can't play like that. But so for little free-for-all tips, since I haven't played free-for-all like forever and a day, is if you are going to use this rushing around style, is to keep your head on a swivel. Single most important thing you can do. And as you can see right there, I threw down the motion sensor. I could hear that guy on my Tritons, and I was like, you know what, let me just throw on this motion sensor real quick and maybe I can find him. And I'm glad I did, because he was camping out behind that lunch table. And you know, it's one of those things, if you're looking to step up your gameplay, you're looking to take your game up to the next level, a couple things you can do on a checklist. First of all, if you're looking to take your game to the next level, one of the easiest things you can do is guys camping. One of the easiest things you can do is to invest in a nice headset. And I know Turtle Beach makes a bunch of headsets. Some of them are expensive and some of them are cheap. This is the type of thing where you get what you pay for. I think, in my personal opinion, I think the best headsets for the dollar are Tritons. They have true Dolby 5.1 surround sound, so there's actually five little speakers in your headset. And the footsteps and all that come out crystal clear. I know Turtle Beach has their brand new headset is really good, but I think it's actually a little more expensive. Of course, Astro's, their more expensive headsets are also their equivalent, I should say, is also very good too, but they're also a little more expensive. But the Tritons seem to have just like a really good, nice, crisp sound. I've never had a problem with them. Their customer service is unbelievable. Every time I've had an issue, a glitch, something broke or whatever, I called them up and they overnighted one to me, or with a part or whatever the case may be. But no questions asked. But that's just my experience with them, and I'm sorry to deviate that from the actual conversation about free-for-all. But if you're looking to step up your game, especially in free-for-all, because you're kind of lone wolfing it, you're not kind of, you are lone wolfing it. You're all by yourself out there, and it's just you versus a bunch of other guys. One of the things you're going to need to step up your game, if you're looking to do so, and you have a little bit extra cash, is to buy a nice gaming headset. And of course, the next thing you could do is to change your sensitivity level. Go up a couple notches. I'm not saying you have to go all the way up to 10 or 12 or wherever the hell it cops off at, but you know, just go up, bump one week and bump another week. Usually if you go from the norm, and if you go up maybe 2, 3, or even 4 stretching it, if you go up about 2 sensitivity levels, then I think you'll find your gameplay improving. You're able to swivel your head a little faster, you're able to move with the guys running a little faster, etc., etc. And I would recommend kind of implementing that in like a weekly regimen. So, you know, 1 week, you bump it up one level, and then you wait maybe a week, and then the next weekend, you bump it up another level. I think you'll find out that it's very easy to get used to. It might be a bit weird for the first hour or so, but after a week, it's going to seem like you never even changed it. And then, of course, you bump it up again, and then you have that same small learning curve, and you'll realize that it just feels like home. So those are just some quick little tips for free-for-all. I know a bunch of people have many different tips for free-for-all. I mean, see here, I know where the hot spots are. I know where the guys are camping at. But that is something that just comes with experience. And unfortunately, there's really not a whole lot you can exchange for experience. It's just actually playing the game. So that would be the last tip. The more you play, the better you'll get. Doesn't matter what mods or hacks or anything, you gotta be able to play good to be able to be good. But you see there, ended up 30-7, not a bad time for my second overall free-for-all and my first free-for-all victory, obviously, by the accolade. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Now, if you're new around here, please feel free to click subscribe, and that will bring my nice variety of first-person shooters directly to your YouTube homepage. You don't have to search all around for good videos of Homefront or Medal of Honor or old Call of Duties or new Call of Duties or old Battlefields or new Battlefields. I play a variety and I post a variety, and I'll bring them right to your YouTube homepage. Video on the right, if you click on that, is you're getting to know your close quarter downloaded content weapons on Battlefield 3. Video on the left is little MW2 on Trailer Park talking about how the developers of Call of Duty have really kind of oversaturated this game, and of course random will be completely random. Also, please feel free to check out some of my French channels. I'll put links to them down in the description. Thanks, guys.
Yells!